Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Syncfusion Blazor Kanban component to a Blazor WebAssembly application and show you how to configure a few of its basic features like populating cards and enabling Swimlane. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create a Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it, along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.8 or .NET 5.0 SDK. .NET Core SDK 3.1.8 requires Visual Studio 2019 16.7 or later, whereas .NET 5.0 requires Visual Studio 2019 16.8 or later. Now, open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Here, I will choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and click the Next button. I will name my project and click Next. Then I select the target framework as .NET Core 3.1 and then click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready for use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the Kanban component to this project. First, I need to install the syncfusion.blazor.kanban package to work with the Kanban component. To do that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, search for the package, and install it in my application. Once installed, you can see the package has been added to this application's packages folder. Then I'll navigate to the _imports.razor page and import the namespace syncfusion.blazor.kanban. Next, I will navigate to the index.html page within the root folder to add a Syncfusion Bootstrap 4 CSS reference from the installed package. Then I need to register for the Syncfusion Blazor services. In the program.cs file, I will import the syncfusion.blazor namespace. Then I register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the @syncfusionblazor method. I also register the license using the syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionlicenseprovider.registerLicense method, in order to avoid the license validation message in output. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, then you can check out the video linked in the card above or in the description below. The configuration steps are done, so let me move on to adding the Blazor Kanban component now. I will open the index.razor page and add the SF Kanban tag. In a Kanban, I can represent each stage of a process by adding columns. To do that, I need to define the column fields, so I declare public class task and define the fields ID, title, status, summary, and assignee with appropriate data types. Then I specify the type of the Kanban component by adding a tValue property and assigning the value as task. I can specify a list of columns using the Kanban columns tag. To specify an individual column, I add the Kanban column tag. Then I specify the column header using the header text property and set its value to to-do. In the same way, I define columns for in progress, testing, and done. Next, I need to populate an empty Kanban with cards. I can define an enumerable object or remote data using the DataSource property. For now, I will create a list variable based on the model class task and then generate the list. Assign this list to the DataSource property of the Kanban component. Then I include the Kanban card settings tag and map the field title to the header field property and the summary field to the content field property. After that, I map the status field as a key field to the Kanban using the key field property. Then I map the key field to each Kanban column. Here I can map multiple fields using a type of list of string, and I map only the open status. In the same way, I map different status to the Kanban columns. Let me run this application and show you Kanban. See here, the Kanban is rendered with the specified columns. Each Kanban column is populated with cards. Title and summary are displayed in the cards. Finally, I will show you how to enable Swimlane in Kanban. A Swimlane is used for grouping cards to provide transparency to the workflow. To demonstrate this, I have already added the assignee field to each list. I add the Kanban Swimlane settings tag and set its key field to assignee. Look here, the Kanban cards are categorized based on the assignee. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen in this video. I have shown you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion Kanban component to it. And then I showed you a few of its basic features, like populating cards and enabling Swimlane. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.